Not all flour is created equal. Here's how to decode the labels. Bread flour is made from wheat with naturally high gluten protein, which is ideal for light, chewy, and well-risen yeasted breads. All-purpose is meant to be more versatile, with lower gluten protein for a tender cake or pastry crumb, but not too low that it won't be strong enough for yeasted breads. That said, the percentage of gluten protein varies widely between all-purpose brands, from 11.5% in King Arthur, to 10 to 11% in Gold Medal, to 9% in White Lily. There just isn't any standard for all-purpose here in the US. One more word on bread flour. You'll notice some brands include a tiny amount of malted barley in the ingredients. It's there to help kickstart fermentation, because the sugars in malted barley are more readily available to the yeast than they are in wheat. Malting means the barley kernels were soaked in water to encourage them to germinate, and then dried again. Germination converts the barley's starch into a more readily digestible sugar for the yeast. Now, bleached versus unbleached. After wheat is milled and the bran and germ sifted out, you're left with flour that is more cream-colored than white. Traditionally, flour was then aged, which means it would be exposed to the natural oxygen in our air. And over time, the pigments would break down and the flour would naturally get whiter. Now, the purpose of aging flour was not actually to whiten the flour. That was just a byproduct. Aging actually strengthens the gluten properties in flour, which makes it that much better for bread baking. But fast forward to our modern industrial food system. We want the same qualities in our flour, but we want them faster. So now we bleach the flour with peroxides and chlorine to get the white look we're accustomed to. And we oxidize the flour not by aging it, but by hitting it with chemicals. Originally, it was potassium bromate, which is now banned in many parts of the world since being identified as a possible carcinogen. In the US, the FDA still permits potassium bromate, though some producers instead use ascorbic acid, which is also known as vitamin C. Finally, all wheat flour, of course, is made from, well, wheat. But whole wheat contains the whole kernel, the bran, germ, and endosperm, while white flour has been sifted down to just the starchy endosperm. If you want to know what incredible flavor and nutrition you lose in this sifting, then I've got a video for you to click at the end of this one. But first, there is something called white whole wheat flour. This is indeed a variety of wheat that yields a light-colored grain that's also milder in flavor than the reddish-brown grains of most bread wheat. In other words, it tastes and looks a lot less whole wheaty, which I guess is good for cakes and pastries where you want to add some extra nutrition. But I wouldn't recommend it for bread, because, you want more flavor, not less, right? Speaking of which, there's another video you can watch all about ancient wheats, which are, in terms of taste, absolute flavor bombs. So go ahead and click away.